up, YouTube? This is James, and I am back today with another Rush reaction. It's been a minute, so I'm excited to get back into doing some reactions and to start off with Rush. So I don't even remember if you guys suggested this one. I saw it in the comments or if I just grabbed it, but I like the name of it, Limelight. So I figured I would go ahead and start with this guy. And man, I wish I could get back on schedule of doing these more consistently, but just hasn't happened recently. So we'll try to knock some out, and hopefully I can record more videos on a more consistent basis soon. But with that said, go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, join the social media channels, share with your friends, all that stuff. And let's check it out. Rush, Limelight. First of all, man, this is a long time ago. They were so young looking that for a second I didn't recognize them or think it was them. But let me know what year this is. Obviously, I could just look it up if I need to. But just off the top, I'm enjoying the instrumental. You know, Rush is on point as usual. And I'm pretty sure the song is what I... is going to be about what I thought it was about, just from the name, and basically their take on being in the limelight. Or, you know, when I say their take, it's going to be pretty deep probably, but yeah, I'll try not to pause it for a little bit and listen, but let me go back. I have to pause just because I'm gonna forget what I was wanting to say about that. And this was so long ago, and it makes me think of what it would have been like for them if they had like the paparazzi and all that stuff back then. Because I know that this makes me think of like Britney Spears losing her mind from being followed around all the time, and like Bieber getting in trouble. You know, partly because he's an idiot, but also, you know, just because he didn't know how to live his life in this spotlight or the limelight. But they talk about how put up a barrier or a wall, you almost have to. And, you know, people have a fascination with being a superstar. Alexa, cancel. Alexa.
I'm having trouble connecting to the internet. Take a look at the help section in your Alexa app.
Yeah, so we're back from that. So yeah, they talk about people having a fascination with it, and you know, I guess the barrier you have to put up is because not everybody is like kind of built to live their life that way. And I know I've been talking a long time, but it also reminds me of like like Eminem, for example, now, like, you know, he's huge, but you don't see him anywhere. You know, very rarely see him out anywhere. He just stays at his house, apparently, in Detroit. And it's because, you know, when he raps about it a lot, like, he doesn't really have a life. He can't have a life. He talks about how it would be great if he could just go to Target and walk around, like, not even to buy stuff, just a shop, but he can't do it. So, yeah, I think that's kind of what they're hitting on here. They're probably hitting on it from three different angles, but we'll keep going. I like that too. I'm sorry to keep pausing, but living in the fisheye lens, because it's the lens that kind of catches everything, so you can't avoid it, which is, you know, pretty cool way to put it. But it talks about, you know, I can't lie and say that I am best friends with a stranger or whatever. You know, all the fans, you know, think they know them personally because they see them so much or whatever, but when they meet the fan, then it's the first time, and it's like, it's hard to, especially if you're not that type of person, like, to fake it and be like, oh, you're my, you know, oh, to reciprocate that interaction. Like, that would be crazy. Those who wish to be must put aside the alienation. Get on with the fascination, the realization. That was a badass little solo and just, I guess, bridge. Maybe the musical term, I'm not even sure. But I noticed that basically lead singer Getty, it's called Mr. Getty, doesn't seem to be playing too many instruments. I mean, it seems like he's on the keyboard right now, but he had his hands on the drums earlier. The bongos, whatever, and so all this sound is coming from two people for the most part, you know, minus the vocals, which is even more impressive. Because usually he's just going crazy with the guitars and everything else, but just something I noticed, all the sound from two people. Living in the limelight, the universal dream. Oh, I say that now he's playing the guitar. Thank you. So that was Rush, Limelight, and you know, maybe he was actually playing, and that was just like a studio session, and so they were showing the different parts and times of the recording or something. Either way, dope instrumental, really enjoyed it. His vocals were like, I think I mentioned or said it in there, like they were soothing almost in that song for whatever reason. But I like the meaning of the song. I don't think I'm not gonna try to tear too deep into it from what I've already said. I think it's just about them dealing with being in the limelight or the spotlight and dealing with fame and how some people, I guess, enjoy it. Other people, not so much. They might put a barrier up, which kind of reminds me of like Pink Floyd, that whole story, which I'm still going through. Catch up, get myself caught up on some stuff, but you can check that out too if you want, in the Pink Floyd playlist. But yeah, good song. So if you did suggest it, thank you. It's been so long, I don't remember, but go ahead and suggest some more Rush songs down below in the comments, and I will get to those. And you know, it's cheesy. Everyone does like the Rush Week and this and that, but would you guys want to see a Rush Week? If so, let me know and I will try to do it so we can get some consistent videos out for a little while. But with that said, thanks for watching and until next time, guys. Deuces.